sign. It is the day of the week from the January 2018. On the week begin from the 15th until the 21st. I want to say thank you to all you Virgos. Thank you for the likes and shares and the support that you have gave me all this time. Welcome all you Virgos, and I hope you will return. I'm sorry. I am speaking too much. This is a week of an Earth week, which is good because a lot of you I see here is getting a new start in this week, which is very good, very positive. Energy of the star is here. You have two major arcana, and these major arcana, especially on Sunday, whatever you think to do on Sunday, it's going to be positive because these major arcana is very good, very positive. What is happening for you is that your own energy vibration is in this week, and the energy of the week, it is your energy vibration. So it is a week for you Virgos, okay? It's a week of balance. This is Friday is going to be very positive, and Sunday is going to be a day. Yes, whatever you decide to do on Sunday, go ahead and do it, okay? The energy, the zodiac energy of the week is hurt, and then as of Friday, it is going to change to the air signs. You have the three of swords energy is a loss. Whatever has transpired, you have a loss, you Virgos, whatever the situation is. You have a loss, so we are going to look at this situation and see what is the loss that is happening in this week for you guys, okay? So I'm going to do a little bit more in-depth reading and hope that I can still get reach at the time to see what is the closures within this. You have the Wheel of Fortune, so whatever that transpired, but I want to see what is happening here. It's good sometimes to see. Energy of the sun is also here, and not the major arcana. The devil is in reverse, which is good. The king of wands is in reverse, and this is good. And you have heartbreak with the energy of a woman. And this is someone over the age of 40 and is an Aquarius, a Gemini, or a Libra. So you have heartbreak with a woman who is an Aquarius, Gemini, or Libra. Okay, so that is where the loss comes in. So let's look at Monday to see what's happening. Monday, you have the energy vibration of an air sign. You have the King of Swords of the Prince, King of Swords. Whoever this person is, whoever this King of Swords is, whoever this person is, this King of Swords, whatever the situation is that is taking place with this King of Swords, there is a loss that came in for you, Geminis, okay? So this King of Swords could be a Aquarius, a Libra, or a Gemini, okay? So you're going to have a situation with this person on Monday. I'm going to go into detail. On Tuesday, you have this conflicts in reverse. The conflicts as now end. Whatever the situation was of it, the conflicts is now end, and whatever the burden was, it has also ended. Okay. Wednesday, and the crowning of your week is the energy of the Ace of Wands. Okay, whatever the situation is of was, this crowning of this week is the Ace of Wands, a new beginning for you Virgos. So in this week, there is going to be a new beginning. Whatever the situation that has transpired between you and that person, it could be your father or a uncle or whatever, there's a new beginning. As we look at the situation that is happening, you have the Nine of Swords in reverse. So all that was happening, all the worries and that sort of a thing, it is now in reverse. The Nine of Swords is in reverse, and the sun comes out. The Nine of Swords is in reverse, and the sun comes out. On Friday, you need to have balance. Whatever is happening, there is people who are of lower energies around you. on Friday, but I'm going to go deeper. But on Friday, you have your own energy vibration. It is a good day, depends on how you deal with it. The Four of Cups is in reverse around it, and the Devil is in reverse around it. Okay, so that means it's going to be good. As we move forward, we have the King of Pentacles. Whoever this King of Pentacles is a Taurus, Virgo, or a Capricorn. This person you have to deal with on Saturday. And this King of Pentacles has somebody who is a Prince of One, and he's in reverse. But we're going to go in more details. We're just letting you understand what is transpiring in this week. Energy of the Star comes up. This is going to be on Sunday. So Sunday is going to be a very, very positive day for you. An extremely positive day for you. Okay. So I'm on time. So I am going to look and see what is going on, because a lot is going on in this week for you guys. Okay. So let's focus and let's take a look at what is going on, because this Ten of Wands with a conflicts, you have the Four of Cups that is between. Okay, so here we go, and here we are taking a look. On Monday, there is a situation that you, a conflict that you guys will have with someone over the age of 40, and he is over the age of 40, and there is this conflict. So he's over the age of 40, and the Five of Wands, there is this conflict, there is this enormous conflict that has been going around. The conflict said is going to be ended on Tuesday. Okay, so this conflict is as if it's coming from the year before. Okay, because if you look at this, there's a heartbreak, there is a heartbreak, a Five of Swords, there's a heartbreak. So this could be some of you who your parents is an Aquarius, a Gemini, or a Libran. There is a conflict that is going on, and that is the conflict, because what is happening, there's a lot of changes that is coming for you. Whatever the conflicts was with the Four of Cups and that sort of a thing, it was as if you should have received some money, which you're not receiving that money, because the energy of the Devil, whatever that has transpired, because you're having balance about this, is as if you did something for people, and now, and for some of you, your mom found out what you have done, and she did not agree with you. So there is a huge conflict what is happening with you and your mom. Whoever this person is like an uncle or someone, and whatever he has done, because what I'm seeing is that it's like it's your uncle, or yeah, it's like an uncle, but someone close to the family. Whatever that they have done, you are so upset with all of these conflicts that has happened. And what is here and what is so powerful is that whoever and whatever has transpired, there is a love that is coming up between you and someone who's a Taurus, Virgo, or Capricorn, because what is happening is this is for yourself. And it's as if something happened. It's as if there is someone who you really care about, and you see all of this happening. And this, a family member who is an Aquarius, a Libra, or a Gemini, has caused all of this conflicts. And whoever they have caused the conflicts about is someone who you really deeply care about. It's someone who you think, oh my God, this person have actually not done anything, and look at what they have done. And you are standing up against it, because you can see here, you know, that you're standing up against this. You're standing up against what they have done, because they have lied and done certain things. And because you have done that, you are having a new beginning, and you're releasing that King of Wands and this Prince of Wands. There is a situation that has transpired, and whoever this air sign is, the Aquarian Gemini, this older person, the Aquarian Gemini, because this person is older than you are, has connected with the Knight of Wands and the King of Wands. You know, he has connected, but it's as if you both are blood relative. You both are blood relative because your mom is his brother. You can see that your mom is his brother, and you have connected with him. Whosoever and whatsoever they have done, your heart bleeds at it because you're so in love. It's someone who you have admire and have respect for, that they have done this, and you're releasing yourself because you found out that they lied. They asked you to do things against this person because it's a woman that you are in love with, who you really care about, and they asked you to do things about this woman. And it can be vice versa, a woman vice versa a man, but right now it is the energy of the men that are coming up, that whatever has transpired, you women, the women needs to have balance because they have a certain situation that they were dealing with, conflicts. The Four of Cups, they should have gotten some money and it didn't happen because the energy of the Devil is in reverse. But as I look at this side, what is happening is that you have the energy of the Star because your heart is clean and you're coming from a good place. Your heart is broken over what they have done and you're releasing them. There is someone who is the Prince of One, and that is an Aries, Leo, or a Sagittarius, and the King of Wands, that is an Aries, Leo, or Sagittarius. Whoever these men were, you are releasing yourself from them and you're going on a new start. You're not worrying anymore about things that will happen and will transpire because the energy of the Sun is going to come out over you, and there's going to be a transition, and you're going to become the Star because you decided to release yourself. You're standing against opposition. Okay, you're standing against opposition because there is definitely what has transpired. Your mother has something to do with it, and your uncle has something to do with it because your mom is the same sign. Your mom is a hair sign who is an Aquarius, a Gemini, an Aquarius, a Gemini, or a Libran, and your uncle or her brother or some relatives of you is also an Aries, a Leo, or an Aries, a Gemini, or a Libran. And whatever that has transpired, it transpired against someone who you really care about, the love of your life, Ace of Cups, a new love. And it's as if they have been, you have been in love with this person, and it's as if they have conjured up a very, very horrible thing. And now you are stepping out. You're stepping out and you want to start a new beginning with the Ace of Wands. There's a transition that is going to come for you because you're going to start a new beginning, and the energy of the Star is here, and the Nine of Swords is in the reverse. So you're not going to worry anymore. You're just going to leave the situation behind and move forward because whatever the oppression is and whatever that is going on, you're going to decide that, you know, I'm not even going to think about this. I'm just going to leave this because, you know, it's hard. It's not good what has transpired, what we have done. It is not good. And I don't want to be a part of this anymore. This is you Virgos, because you Virgos can be very, very placent, but whenever you see injustice is happening to someone else, you decided to step away and to move away because obviously this is going to affect you, the Virgos, whose mother is an Aquarian, Gemini, or Libran, okay? And you are going to feel heartbroken about your mom because you couldn't understand that your mom could have done something like this. It's as if you have seen your mom in a light that you feel heartbroken about because your mom did something, and your mom and someone else, your mom, and it's like your uncle. For some people, it doesn't have to be an uncle, but it's like your mom and another man really conjured up against someone who you care about so much, someone who's very, very, has a very beautiful soul, and you care about this person. So it can be that you are a woman, Virgo, and your mom is an Aquarius, a Gemini or a Libra, and she conjured up against, you know, a good friend or a friend of the family or something like that, and you decided, I'm ending this, I don't want to be a part of this, and you're moving forward, and you decided that, you know, I can't believe that my mom would do something like that. And for you, it's an eye-opener. And you're saying to them, you know, I don't want to have any more connection with you. You know, you have chose, you're going to choose your family and move away from this. And as you do that, I don't think some of you are really not going to speak to your mom anymore. Some of you are going to be you know, disintegrating yourself from your mom because of this situation, because and you know what is going to happen, there's an healing is going to come in, and the healing what is going to come in is going to show you how you know, you are a good person. If even you were thinking, you know, who am I? You're going to see that you're a good person, because whosoever they're doing the thing about whosoever they try and conjure up against, you love that person, you think the world of the person, and your heart breaks to see this happening, okay? But not to worry, the energy of the sun is going to come out. Self-worth. This is a perfect reading for you. Self-worth. You have found your self-worth, and you have found who you are, and you know who you are, and this is why you decide to leave them in this nasty thing that they have done. It's very, very bad when people tend to conjure it up around other people, and here the self-worth, you have found your self-worth, and you're going to think, I am beautiful the way I am. And even though my mom has always let me feel as if I was such a bad person, now I see the evil that is in my mom, okay? Yes, it can. Uh-huh. X-ray vision. And this is good because you're seeing things clearly. You're finally seeing things clearly. You're seeing things clearly. And you know, if you're a man and this happens to you, not all women are like that. Your mom is just not learning what she's supposed to learn in this lifetime. Do not be appalled at this, because even people who have kids can be very nasty too, and this is what is happening. Leave her, because the same thing that she has done to someone is going to happen to her, so not to worry about it, okay, my darling? I'm wishing you a wonderful week. I hope everything will work out for you. There's going to be a lot of accomplishment for you. Good things are going to happen to you, not to worry. Love is very powerful, and at some stage, maybe you can reach out to that person and let that person know exactly what has transpired and tell them, you know, if I have been a part of it, I'm so sorry. But let that person be aware of what has transpired. Namaste.